enemy the way the National Para Athletics Championship has behaved with India's differently abled athletes. They were forced to sleep on the floor, bath and defecate in the open, and there were no special facilities like ramps. But has this evoked the outrage it should have? And does it reveal the shameful way India responds to the differently abled? My guests are the well-known columnist and commentator Akar Patel, former world billiards champion Michael Ferreira, the sports advisor of the Hindustan Times, Pradeep Magazine, and table tennis player and disabled rights activist Pradeep Raj. Akar Patel, first the Times of India and then all national television channels have revealed the disgusting conditions in which differently abled athletes were hosted at the National Para Athletics Championship. They were forced to sleep on the floor, bath and defecate in the open, and there were no special facilities like ramps. What words would you use to describe this situation?
I would say it's normal. I think in a nation where words like langda, lula, kana are nicknames, where we tend to look at people through their handicap without much sympathy, and I mean all of us, not just the government, this is only to be expected. I think that we ought not to be surprised that there was very little facility available for people who needed it, and I don't think that there was any sort of thinking that went on in the background of calling so many people together in one place. And I doubt whether anybody gave it a thought on what these people needed or whether they were special in any way. I'm not at all surprised. I'm not even outraged. I don't think that this thing will stop. I think the next games next year will be quite similar. I think there is a second aspect to this. I don't think we should be viewing this purely through the prism of their disability. This is the way it is in every sports event. You and I have been to sports events outside of our cities when we were young. It was no different even when we were enabled physically. Other than our hallowed cricket team, nobody really gets good the facilities in India.
You know, Pradeep Raj, there was a large element of deliberate tongue-in-cheek comment there from Akar Patel. But as someone who is differently abled yourself, were you surprised and shaken by what you saw on television, what you read in the Times of India yesterday? Or do you agree that this is precisely how the differently abled are treated by India? That it may be shocking when it becomes public, but this is how people like you have to live your lives? Pradeep, can you hear me?
Hello.
Can you hear me? Did you hear that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. सर, कैन यू प्लीज दोबारा से सर थोड़ा
जी जरूर. मैं ये पूछ रहा था कि डू यू बिलीव दैट व्हाट यू सॉ ऑन टीवी यस्टरडे इज शॉकिंग एंड डिसगस्टिंग?
यस सर, यस सर.
और इज दिस हाउ पीपल लाइक यू हैव हैड टू लिव देयर लाइफ? वी आर सरप्राइज्ड बिकॉज वी हैवंट रियलाइज्ड इट, बट दिस इज द रियलिटी फॉर यू.
यस सर, मैं सबसे पहले बताना चाहूंगा कि जिस तरह से ये अपने आप को बचाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि इनके पास फंड्स की प्रॉब्लम थी, तो मेरा सबसे बड़ा पहले क्वेश्चन ये है कि अगर आपके पास फंड नहीं था तो आप इतने बड़े इवेंट के लिए गए क्यों? और मैं उसके बाद ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि ये कह रहे हैं कि इनको स्पोर्ट्स मिनिस्ट्री ने कोई फंड नहीं किया है. मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूँ 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009 हर नेशनल इवेंट के लिए मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स ने इनको 5 लाख रुपये से ज़्यादा का फंड किया है. तो ये सिर्फ एक बहाना है और बचने की कोशिश है पैरालंपिक कमेटी ऑफ इंडिया की. और ये पहली बार नहीं हुआ है सर, ये बैंगलोर में जितने भी इन्होंने इवेंट्स कराए हैं इसी तरीके के ये अरेंजमेंट प्रोवाइड कराते हैं एथलीट्स को, क्योंकि यहाँ पर ये दिल्ली एनसीआर में था और ये मीडिया की पकड़ में आ गया, इस वजह से ये हाईलाइट हुआ है. अदरवाइज ये बैंगलोर में होता या कहीं होता तो इतना हाईलाइट नहीं होता और इसी तरह से सब कुछ चलता रहता.
माइकल फेरेरा, आफ्टर द टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया ब्रोक दिस हॉरिबल स्टोरी यस्टरडे ऑन इट्स फ्रंट पेज, स्पोर्ट्स मिनिस्टर सर्बानंद सोनोवाल ट्वीटेड that he has asked for a detailed report from the Paralympics Committee of India. But as far as I can tell, that's the only reaction from the government. It's the only reaction from the minister. It's the only reaction from anyone in the Modi government. Is that anywhere like the sort of response you expect? Is it anywhere close to adequate?
Absolutely not. You know, Karan, I think the whole issue basically stems from the fact that no one gives a damn about the Paralympics, the para-athletes, or the differently abled athletes. It's not a glamour event. They are not glamour boys. No one gives a damn. And you know, if you're going to hold a championship of the stature of the national championship of the country, There should have been a dummy run done by the PCI, the organizers. They should have gone ahead, seen whether everything was in order, like all of us did when we were in administration, sussed out the situation, and plugged the gaps and the leaks wherever possible. This was not done. And every national championship is funded by the sports ministry or by the government or whichever arm of the government to a certain extent. I know that in my game it was 10 lakhs. Perhaps it was less for the Paralympics, although it shouldn't be. Now, were these funds made available or not? One of the defects in this system is that the government does not advance the funds. They give you the funds after the event is over and you've shown what you've done. This, I think, needs urgent review.
Okay.
Because funds are the very lifeblood of sport.
So the money must be made available upfront.
Yeah, review the system. Okay. And monitor it very, very strictly. Also, in the case of the less glamorous sports, and I use the word sadly, there should be a strict monitoring either by the SAI with an overview by the sports ministry.
Okay.
This should be a given. This should be written into the system.
Oh, Pradeep Magazine, you heard Michael Ferreira begin by referring, in fact, to the Paralympic Committee and how they should have monitored this done a dummy run. Now, in fact, yesterday in the Times of India, when they broke the story, Rajesh Tomar, the president of the Paralympics Committee of India, claims that he was aware that the games were poorly organized and managed, but he blames this on the organizing secretary. But the amazing thing is that you discover from that article that he made these statements without visiting the venue, and he'd presumably never been to the venue because otherwise he'd have seen what the situation was like, and secondly, without any personal knowledge of the situation. Now, isn't that, from the president of the Paralympics, another example of gross irresponsibility?
Look, I checked the website of this association, PCI, and Mr. Tomar is highlighted there. He's an IRS officer. He's not somebody who's insignificant. He knows, and his administrative qualities are there, written as mentioned as something which he's bringing this to this kind of an association. So obviously, he has not cared, and I will go with Akar Patel. You know, we have hierarchies in this country. It's not just to do with, we don't care for our poorer people, we don't care for our, like, we have a caste structure. So in this hierarchy, differently abled athletes, like it's a system where probably these people think they are obliging them by this very fact that by even bringing them there, it's a very shocking, shameful, another episode of the way we treat people.
Akar Patel, in my introduction I said, or I asked the question, is this a national shame that hasn't quite shamed the nation? Do you believe that this is the sort of thing we not only take in our stride, but we have, leave aside, no guilt about, we often don't care about it?
Well, I don't think we feel a sense of shame over this. I don't think we have the conscience to be able to look at somebody who has been born with a handicap with any sort of sympathy. There is no sympathy in the way that we look at such people. And as I told you, our nicknames for them reveal that. There's a very famous kababi in Lucknow called Tunde, which means somebody with no arms. Though I don't know whether he lasts very long given the ban on beef over the country. But I'm saying that is a reflection of the way we are as people, that we tend to look at physical